Well, all I can say is Antics outdone themselves. We're here to review this one today. Take a look at this. This is the Antec P380. And to be honest with you, you will want to stick around for the full review. So Antec, you've made me look around this case for 15 minutes and I'm still trying to wonder how to get this front off. Well, obviously I'm building a computer in it and this is going to be a full review on this case, the P380, and we're going to obviously find out how much space we've got to put graphics cards in, motherboards, if we can get any CD or DVD drives, Blu-ray drives, whatever you want to call it. And that's about 2015, people normally use USBs, but that's another thing about the USBs. I've seen that you can have this USB switch from this side to that side. And I've also seen on the front here that you've got a power switch and reset switch on the left hand side as well as the right hand side. Literally, Antec's outdone themselves with this one. Embroidered Antec label on the front there, as well as like some nice easy grab thumb screws, I should say. Lovely window on the side here, brushed powdered side. It's got air vents that look like something out of a Lamborghini or a Ferrari car or something. Looks like this case would definitely breathe very, very well. Let's see what's underneath in the window. I can see two 140mm fans. And it looks like there'll be space for a radiator of a 360 radiator at the top there. And maybe you can put one in the front there. We all know when we get the case undone. And it also comes with a dust filter as well, which is quite good. Nice and easy. Literally everything stays in the case. You just put it out, bang, and then start vacuuming, or not vacuuming actually, using some sort of thing that doesn't create static. That's the one I'm meant to say. On the front here, it's got a dust filter, a honeycomb one. Still don't know how to get in there, but I will do. I know there's some screws underneath there. And I know the top can come off as well, this beautiful case. There's also a 120mm fan on the back there, so you can have a single or a push and pull configuration of water cooling, like a custom sort of water cooling kit inside here. It's got enough expansion bays here. The power supply room looks okay. It's got grommets in there. You know what, let's actually take this case and open it and find out what we've actually really got. That's the main thing. Antec sent us a VPF 650 power supply, which we're going to be putting into this case, as well as a Gigabyte G1 gaming motherboard, as well as paired up with some Corsair 2100 megahertz of DDR3 by Corsair, the Dominant Platinum RAM. And we're going to put a Corsair water cooling kit on there, just something very straightforward. A Toshiba 1 terabyte hard drive, the new one. I'll leave a link down below so you know what one I'm talking about. And also we're going to put in a Western Black, it's a mixture of both. It's got a solid state, which is 128 gig, and it's also got a 1 terabyte hard drive built into one hard drive. And and the processor is going to be a 4770K, and it's going to be overclocked as well. Oh, also, the graphics card, don't forget the graphics card, it's going to be a GTX 970 that's going to be going in there, and we're going to see what it looks like. To be honest with you, I didn't go too crazy with the price and stuff, but everything's going to be left down in the link down below so you can actually see how much everything costs and where to purchase this stuff. But what we're going to do, we're going to speed this up now because I'm going to take this case apart and I'm going to stop talking. I can see here as well that you've got 1, 2, 3, which means that you can literally pull out the whole tray and pull that tray out, and obviously put another water cord in here, or you can do certain things to it. There's so many things that you can actually do to this case, and it's not like overly massively big, it's just perfect. Also, every tray that you've got, it's easy to pull out and bring out a 3.5mm tray, as well as each one has space for a 2.5 inch solid state drive or a normal hard drive, or one like this, which is a dual drive. So you could have so much storage all on here, or you can just take storage away, put fans in there, whatever you want to do to it. You can see there's 1, 2, 3, 4 big grommet hole links, no removable tray, but it looks like you can still work for the back of the tray when you're actually putting the custom cooling plate for the water cooling to go on the back of a motherboard. Or if it's just a fan, just straight on there with the back plate, no problems. And you've got already installed is the actual standoffs, nice brass ones. This fits extra big motherboards, ATX, the standard ones, and micro ATX, and obviously the smaller one. So this fits all. And on the back, it's got one of the special Antec little fan bits that goes on the back. It's got 1-4 Monix connector, and it's got 6 3-pin each fan like holder, where you can obviously power the fans from the back, so keep everything tidy from not being in the front, as long as the cables are long enough. And yeah, it just looks pretty tidy. There's a room there, enough of great cable management here. It's also got air vents on the back here on the side there for the cables to breathe, as well as the side here for water cooling. And yeah, the metal on the bottom here feels a bit more softer, but it's not making the case anything lighter or like a bit loose or anything like that. This case feels strong as they come. It is built like a tank. I can see that there's 2 spots there for 2 CD drives or DVD drives or Blu-ray drives, whatever you drives you want to call them, but I still don't know how to get the front off. So we'll have a look and find out what we can do there. And also on the back here as well, there's a sort of fan controller just situated in the back of the cable, didn't miss that. And also on here is obviously a USB 3 connector, as well as a USB connector to the side, and obviously the HD and your 9 audio, HD audio now. And what's this, USB again, 1 Molex, I hate Molex, but still it's on there. Oh, there's another fan controller there as well, so that's good, there's 2 of them. That's for the top one, so that's pretty cool. And what else we got here, just looks really nice and breathable. It's got the rubber bits at the bottom. So we're going to go back to the case, because I forgot to tell you is that it's got, if you've got obviously a normal hard drive, 3.5, which means it's mechanical, means it's going to be vibration. They actually thought about putting each rubber sealant on the bottom here to keep the vibrations at bay. So you won't actually, it'll be a super quiet case basically, especially paired up with some Noctura fans. Ooh, that would be cool. And on the bottom, what have we got here? I still don't know what this is either, Antec. I don't know what that is yet, but I'll find out. So on the bottom here, we've got rubber grommets, and let's see. They haven't got screws in them, but they've been pushed in and settled in into the bottom of the case, which is really nice. That means there'll be less vibrations, means it'll be nice and quiet as well. As I was saying about the filler sort of aluminium at the bottom, it's got screws, a couple of pot rivets. Oh, there's some screws at the bottom. That must be to get the front off, to obviously reveal the CD drives and stuff like that. Nice air vent at the bottom there. Plenty of room for this case to breathe, and it definitely can fit 120mm fans at the top here. Don't know about push and pull configurations, can't see the width of it yet, but we'll open it up now and let's have a look. So as you can see here, we've got 2 USB 3s on the side here and 2 USB 2s, and we've got a microphone jack and a headphone jack, and a microphone jack, both 3.5mm, and this could be actually swapped and turned over to the other side. So this is how you get this unfinger magnet top off. You take the two thumb screws at the back and then you just press with the back of your fingers on the back and it slides. And there we go, we can reveal the top of the fans now. So that's perfect. See the grills there for great fan insulation. The this is quite plasticky, so I'm guessing because it's hidden, it just used a slightly cheaper plastic on the top, so with the air vents, but on the other side it just looks beautiful and everything like that, so you won't be seeing that. Yep, as I said, 140 on the top, 140 on the top. You can fit three 120s at the top here, no problem. Looks like a bit of an ease, definitely. And the USB, obviously it's here. You take the two screws off the top here, and then you obviously take this out and swap this right round and put it in there, and take that plate and put it in that side. So simple. And Tech have really definitely outdone themselves here, keeping the cost down and obviously still sticking with quality. Much better than the Antec 1900, I would say. So I'm quite happy with that. So let's put a computer in there and see what it looks like, and we'll get the measurements and stuff so everyone can see like what you can actually fit in this case properly. Right, I've just been upstairs because I forgot to say, before any attempt at making and building a computer, you should always test your components first, like motherboard, graphics card, power supply, hard drive, because all of that could be dead on arrival, or any like component could be dead. So it's always good, test it all out first before you start doing water cooling or custom water cooling or credit cooling, whatever you want to do with building a PC. Always, I stress, test it first before anything's wrong with it, that you built it all up and it doesn't work anymore and you don't know what it is, you have to start taking components apart. Always test it out the box first, or outside the case first. Thank you.
tasting the salt from their tears. To find a heart deep on their fingers. Tasting the salt from their tears.
See, this computer is completely built now. It looks like a complete mess, but this is a case review just to show you what you can use with it. Now I'm using a budget Antec VPF 650 power supply, which is more than enough for the GTX 670 graphics card that I've got in there with 4 gigs of RAM. Also 16 gig of DDR3 Platinum edition, which is 2100 megahertz per channel. I'm also using a Gigabyte G1 motherboard, which is a bit mad because obviously inside the case the motherboard could be a bit bigger, but I thought I'm going to just use certain bits that are powerful enough and just to show off the case. The power supply, it's got funny cables, which doesn't look good for aesthetics. It's not long enough to hide cables for the grommets. The case actually has grommets that are a little bit weak and it comes out pretty easily like this does, but it's quite an easy fix to fix it. But if you move the cable a little bit, it'll pull it all out. So if you're doing everything to make it look nice, that's what will happen. Obviously it fits a nice single 120mm water cooling kit right here, no problem. Just like the hard drives are fine, you can cable management all the back perfectly. I think it's just down to the power supply wasn't big enough. If you've got all nice braided cables and everything like that, it's going to look absolutely stunning in this case, especially with the window. But as you can see that I went for a multicolored look, but this is just to show off the case that I'm just using the budget sort of components in here, just to show you like what it actually looks like with the case with it all built in, because it'd be kind of boring without actually having anything in the case. So that's what I've done. So if you thought this review is helpful, or you want to leave me some comments and ask me some questions of like some problems you might be having if you've got this case or you're thinking about getting this case, I'm real social, so just literally hit me up on YouTube, Facebook or Twitter and I'll answer your questions as soon as I can. And don't forget to obviously stick around and like more of these videos, because I'm always going to keep doing them and doing different ones. And thanks for watching.